uit Dessay in Frans en dan maar hier uit die 380mm gun sight. Het was een German position. This position was shooting at the at Verdun and the surrounding areas. So this is one of the guns. Don't know if this was an original gun because this was just placed this year. As you can see, this thing is massive. Shut up. Probably was sabotaged by the Germans after they left. This one was Max. You can see the range of the Deuce gun. It could shoot at Fort De Mans, Fort Volks and Molenville. And that's for Dunn. The gun at Hempoint could shoot in Lonville, Nancy, and Donbassel. Okay. We're going to have a look. Sorry, you guys, for the quality of the video and for that zooming sound you hear every few seconds. That's the automatic zoom. of the other underground bunkers. It's literally filled with water. This is a munitions bunker with an old cart. Going to fix the light for you guys because this is a bit too dark. So that's one of the exit halls in this tunnel. I think it's collapsed further on. Another exit. That's one of the other exit holes. It's really cold down here. And really wet. Oh, that's a lot of mud. Go any further. It's too much water. And an iron plate that I don't want to fall through. So yeah. It's almost stuck in the mud. Man, look if I can take a picture right here. And back in the heat. Going to have a look at the other tunnel. Maybe that's one is not so squishy and wet. Here's another one. There's a lot of insects in here. I think this one is just as muddy as the other one. I think even worse. Yeah. Oh, nope. It's not going to be it. It's one big pile of mud. Thank you. one of the underground tunnels. Points of the tunnel where I was in a few moments ago. Another one of the exit points or air intakes, yeah, air ducts. Another air intake over here. Trench leading out of the exit of the tunnel where I couldn't get to because it's all muddy and stuff. Here you can see the two tunnels coming together. The old railway track is still in the ground here. To supply the cannon with shells and powder, the logistics mainly relied on a rail network. Shells which arrived in the station in Arans were taken further by means of normal civilian rail links to a station on purpose built rail junction next to the farm of Andyville, 1500 meters from here, and branch line directly links to that station and to this site. So these railway tracks. Go all the way to the town. Let's stop here. Looks like they've been previously uncovered and somebody dug this hole where the track would have gone to. Probably two tracks. Get supplies moving along. So maybe due to time they're all gone. I saw some pictures of some sandbags lying around, but by the looks of it, this place wasn't really maintained very well until recently. And there are a lot of animals around. There's all sorts of things moving around in the bushes. There's another sign. It's about the railway. And here I saw some sandbags. Yeah. It all scatters around right now. This moment. Not really in the place where the Germans left them, I think. sad. What more sandbags with those came from? They still have the imprint of a sack on them, as you can see. It's amazing. Shells standing over there. Have a look at that one, and that's the last one. And a little birdie over there. That's one of the shells. .380 millimeters. And yeah, I think this is it. There's one other tunnel over here. Like all the others, just a swimming pool. Really see a crack on this one. Probably hit by artillery or just the earth moving it around. But yeah, I will see you guys in the next video at Verdun. See you guys next time. Goodbye.